Hey, Ron McGill here with another episode of Zoocademy. Today we're talking about the largest, the greatest of the great apes, the gorilla. Here at Zoo Miami, we have two lowland gorillas. They're both males. We call it our bachelor pad. It's Barney, who's about 27 years old, 26 years old, and then there's Shango, who's 31 years old. These two guys are brothers, and we have them here at this time because really, there's no females for them at the time. Females, generally speaking, you can only put one adult male with the female. So we're a holding facility right now for these two guys until we can find the females for them. Now, there are two basic groups of gorillas. There's the mountain gorillas and there are the lowland gorillas. There's some subspecies in the lowland gorilla groups, but generally speaking, the mountain gorillas tend to have that thick hair. They're found in the mountains of the Congo, Rwanda, and Uganda. Here, the lowland gorillas are found down in the lower areas. Gorillas grow to be the largest of the great apes. Again, not monkeys. Remember, all monkeys, true monkeys, have a tail. Apes do not have tails, so that's one of the big differences. Now, gorilla males are called many times silverbacks as adults. They get that name because of the silver coloring that occurs on their back when their hairs on their back turn gray, which even in human beings is a distinguished look. In gorillas, it is a sign that they have reached sexual maturity. Now, Shango and Barney will often get into little confrontations out here on the exhibit. Even though there are no females, they still are always trying to establish who the alpha male is. So you'll sometimes see them running around and doing a lot of mock charges. Rarely do they come in physical contact. It's a lot more show than it is actual contact. But this is part of the establishment of the hierarchy in the gorilla group. Now, gorillas, believe it or not, are not these malicious monsters that people so many times think they are. Too many movies like King Kong and other monster movies have portrayed them in a negative light. The reality is they're vegetarians. They don't even eat meat. A large male gorilla can eat up to 40 pounds of vegetation every day. You also notice that gorillas have a very large, it almost looks like bloated stomach. People will look at the males and think, oh my God, is he pregnant? Well, no, he's not pregnant. But because of their digestive tract, to be able to digest all of that roughage that they eat, all kinds of wild celery and other kinds of wild plants, it needs all of those intestines, that big digestive tract that gives them that big belly. Quite often they'll get a lot of gas. I've seen them in the wild where you hear all kinds of sounds of these gorillas tooting away. So it really is kind of interesting to watch them. But again, these are not the malicious monsters people make them out to be. They are gentle giants, highly endangered like all of the great apes are. One of their biggest threats is not only deforestation, but killing them for bushmeat. People who actually eat them as a part of a cultural thing of eating bushmeat in the wild areas where they occur. Hopefully through education and understanding, people will realize that this is not the right thing to do, and that information will trickle down, and hopefully that cultural belief will change so we can protect these majestic animals. Hey, I'm Ron McGill here in my office at Zoo Miami. I hope you're enjoying Zoocademy. And listen, if you've got any questions regarding any of the things you see on any of the segments, please email them to education@zoomiami.org. And hopefully I can get to some of them in future segments and give you some good answers. We'll see you around.